Hey everybody, this video is about the surrounding background snake, Crotalus adamantus. From this video, you will learn the classification, identification, history, and behavior of this very unique snake. A quick rundown of its classification, you'll see that it is a part of the reptile class, in case you didn't know that already. It is a part of the snakes and lizards order, known as Squamata. Surrounding background snake is a member of the Viperidae family, and like all members of this family, they have special heat-sensing pits that I'll discuss more in depth on later on in this video. The brief history of this snake shows that it is a particularly terrestrial animal, however sometimes it can be found in trees, but it is very rare. Like many other reptiles, they are ectothermic and poikilothermic. They feed on a number of animals, but they may enjoy eating rabbits and rats. Seeing that they are an ambush predator, these undoubted background snakes remain tightly coiled when they hunt for their prey. They can even stay in that same coiled position for about up to a week long. Looking at its range map on the slide here, you'll see that they do not have a big range as a species, mainly because their habitat is being destroyed by urbanization. But as an individual, its home range can be up to 500 acres. A few distinguishing characteristics can help identify the species out in the wild. Given its name, it has a large row of diamonds that are brown and bordered down its back. Its body color ranges from olive, brown, and black. They have a very large head with that has a vertical pupil. This vertical pupil is also a characteristic of venomous snakes. In the eastern mountain background snake, their pupil has a white stripe that runs diagonally through it. When looking at males and females, there are no real differences between them, so it can make it kind of difficult for distinguishing gender between them. Adults and juveniles also are very similar in patterns, however that the adult is bigger and the juvenile is smaller, so it makes identifying them easier by just looking at the size. So from its name, it does have a rattle because it is a rattlesnake. The rattle is at the end of the tail, and it's primarily used for warning when something or someone is approaching too closely to its territory. The behavior of the eastern diamondback rattlesnake is primarily solitary. However, they do have a male dominant system when competing for a female. So the males will have combat sessions where they intertwine their necks and body and try and push each other over, so it's pretty much like wrestling. To try and win the female over for reproduction. This is a crepuscular species, meaning that they are most active during the morning and at night. The female eastern diamond background snake has a brood size that can range anywhere from 6 young to 21 young. A couple of interesting tidbits for you guys before I leave. They are the largest venomous snake in North America. And as I mentioned before in this video, they have special heat-sensing pits. These heat-sensing pits are located between the nostril and the eye, and they help them find food in the dark. So, as I said before, they are most active during the morning and at night, and sometimes it can be dark, so it can make it difficult to find prey. But when the rattlesnake flicks out its tongue, it gathers chemical receptors in the air, and it touches the pit organ, and from there they can see if there's any food out there in the dark by seeing the heat radiation off of the prey. Another interesting fact is that they construct up to 2/3 of its body length, so a 6-foot snake can construct up to 4 feet. So when looking at these snakes in the wild, you really want to make sure that you had a safe distance from them, otherwise you may get bit. They are cylindrical, so their fangs fold back into its mouth. And their venom is hemolytic, meaning that it breaks down the blood tissue. And it has been known to be fatal in some cases, but it is not as brutal as other venomous snakes out there. And these are just my references that I used in this video. Thank you for your time, guys.